the previous chapter, we have seen about the personal pronouns and what are pronouns we have already seen. Now we will see the other types of pronouns also, and we are going to study about the six types of pronouns in this chapter. Okay, so what are they? I am writing over here. First is demonstrative pronoun. Second is interrogative pronoun. Third is possessive pronoun. Fourth is reflexive pronoun. Fifth, emphatic pronoun. Emphatic pronoun. And the last one is relative pronoun. Now, I will understand these types of pronouns one by one. So, first I am taking what? Demonstrative pronouns. Now, what are demonstrative pronouns?
So, demonstrative pronouns are pronouns that stand for nouns and they are used alone without the nouns they stand for. Okay, so they are used alone in the sentence, they will stand alone and they will stand for nouns in the sentence. Let's suppose if I am giving you an example over here, you can see that was my grandma's table. As you all know, the demonstrative pronouns are used to point out at the nouns. Okay, so whenever we are pointing out to something, that time we will be using demonstrative pronouns, and the demonstrative pronouns which we know are what? This, that, these, those. For the things that are near us, we will use this and these. For the things that are far away from us, For them we will be using that and those. Okay, if we are talking about one thing only, then we will be using this. If we are talking about more than one thing, then we will be using these. Okay, and if we are talking about the thing that is one but is actually far away from us, okay, it is just one only. For that time, we will be using that as a demonstrative pronoun. And if the things that are far away from us and are more than one, then that time we will be using those. Okay, so this, that, these, those are some of the demonstrative pronouns. Okay, now, so here you can see that is pointing out towards what? That was my grandma's table. So that is acting as what? It is acting as a demonstrative pronoun and it is standing alone. It stands for the noun. That is standing for what? For the noun, which is what? Table. Okay. So now, this is demonstrative pronoun. Now, don't get confused between demonstrative pronouns and adjectives. So here you can see that this is what? This is a demonstrative pronoun. That over here is what? Demonstrative pronoun. But I am writing one more example over here. You can look over here. That is, those books are mine. So here you can see that what are demonstrative adjectives? So demonstrative adjectives, they answer the question with which books are mine. So the answer we are getting as those. Okay, and they are always followed by the noun, they qualify. So which noun we are referring, this demonstrative adjective is referring to what?
books. Okay, so it is this, those is describing us, it is telling us about, it is qualifying what? It is those is qualifying books over there. Okay, and it is always, those is followed by the noun. Okay, so here you can see. So those, it is acting as a demonstrative adjective over here. See the difference between both of them. Here in demonstrative pronouns, they stand for nouns and they are used alone, and here it will always come before the noun, it is qualifying. Okay, just remember that. Now moving to the next type of pronoun, that is what? That is interrogative pronoun. We'll be seeing interrogative pronoun now. Okay, so now for interrogative pronouns, so interrogative pronouns are used to ask questions and they also stand alone. Okay, so interrogative pronouns are used to ask what? To ask questions. Okay, and they stand alone without the noun they are used for, they stand for. Okay, so I am giving you an example for interrogative pronoun, which is Neha's book, question mark. Okay, so here some of the interrogative pronouns that we know are who, whom, which, whose, what. Here all the WH family words are categorized into interrogative pronouns. Okay, and here you can see that which is used to ask question and it is standing alone, it is standing for the noun. Okay, so but now let's see about interrogative adjectives. So it describes, as we know that interrogative adjectives describe a noun. Okay, so I'm giving you an example. Whose house was burgled last night. Okay, so here you can see it is describing us, it is describing a noun over here. Whose is the interrogative adjective and it is describing us about the noun, which is house. Okay, so it is used to ask a question and they are used alone. Okay, and here it describes a noun. So it is used alone. Interrogative pronouns are used alone without the nouns they stand for, and it always comes with the noun because it is describing a noun to us. Okay, so this is interrogative pronoun, which is over here is interrogative pronoun, and whose over here is interrogative adjective. Okay, now let's see the possessive pronouns. Now we'll be seeing the next type of pronoun, which is possessive pronouns, which is given on page number 95. Okay, so possessive pronouns are those pronouns which are used to replace the nouns in the sentence that are showing the ownership or the possession. Okay, so these pronouns are used to show the ownership or possession of something. Okay, so I'm writing over here, they replace the nouns in a sentence and show the ownership or possession. Or possession. Okay, so now you can see, I'm giving you an example to understand this possessive pronouns more clearly. Okay, the phone that is ringing. Is yours. Okay, so you can see the phone that is ringing is yours. So now you can see what? That which pronoun is showing us the possession that is yours. That the phone which is ringing, it belongs to you. Okay, so which pronoun is showing the possession? That is yours. Okay, so yours is the pronoun which is showing us the possession of the ownership of the phone which is ringing, that is ringing, okay? So yours is the possessive pronoun. Now let's see the difference between possessive pronoun and possessive adjectives. Now possessive adjectives, they go before the nouns in the sentence, okay? And to show that something or someone, like something or someone belongs to somebody, they show possession as we know, but it let us know to whom the noun belongs, the noun belongs, okay? So here they will always come before the noun in the sentence, and here we are replacing the noun with a pronoun, okay? And in the demonstrative adjective, it will come with the noun, it will come before the noun. You can see this is my book. Over here you can see my, which is what? It is showing us the possession that the book belongs to me. Okay, so here directly it is given that book, it is coming before the noun. Okay, so my is demonstrative adjective. Okay, now moving further to another type of pronoun, that is what? Reflexive pronoun. Okay, now we are doing reflexive pronouns. So now reflexive pronouns are what? That reflexive pronouns are used as the object of the verb when the action of the verb returns to the doer. So here the subject and the object refers to the same noun or pronoun over. Okay, so here you can see the doer of the action is the receiver of the action, that is the reflexive pronoun. I'm writing an example over here, that is, we blame ourselves for the accident. You can see the doer of the action is the receiver of the action, isn't it? The subject and the object refer to the same person. Okay, so here same noun or same noun or pronoun. Here the subject and the object are referring to the same noun or pronoun. Okay, and you can see it is coming after the verb also. This ourselves is coming after the verb, and ourselves is only the reflexive pronoun. Okay, it will be coming according to the subject of the sentence. If the subject is I, then it here the doer of the object of the noun or pronoun will be what? It will be myself. Okay, I blame myself for the accident. If I am changing the subject to he, then he blame himself for the accident. Like this, there would be a change in the pronouns when the subjects are changing. So if I am changing the subject to she, then here herself will come. Okay, so ourselves is what? Ourselves is the reflexive pronoun. Okay, and it is working as what? It is working as reflexive pronoun. So we have some reflexive pronouns that are ourselves, yourself, itself. Okay, I'm giving you one more example. Mother is teaching herself how to drive. You can see the subject of the sentence is the receiver, the subject of the sentence is the receiver of the action, isn't it? The doer of the action is the receiver of the action. Okay, so the subject and the object refer to the same noun or pronoun. Okay, so that is why herself is what? It is a reflexive pronoun. Now we'll be seeing the another type of pronoun. Now let's see what are emphatic pronouns. Okay, so emphatic pronouns are those pronouns which put emphasis on the doer of the action or on the subject. It gives importance to the subject. It emphasizes the subject or the doer of the action. Okay, so you can see over here an example I am writing. She herself informed me about the contest. Okay, so here you can see that she is the subject or the doer of the action and herself. It is emphasizing the subject. It is giving importance to the subject over here. Okay, so herself is the emphatic pronoun. Don't get confused between the reflexive and the emphatic pronoun, because reflexive pronoun, in the reflexive pronoun, the subject and the object refer to the same person. But here we are seeing as that the emphatic pronoun put emphasis only on the subject of the action or of the sentence or the doer of the action. Okay, an emphatic pronoun cannot be used, that herself cannot be used as the subject of the sentence. It cannot be used as the subject of the sentence because it itself is giving us, it is giving the importance to the subject. But that is why this herself cannot be the subject of the sentence. Okay. So, emphatic pronouns are usually placed immediately after the noun which they emphasize. So, you can see over here, after she, what is coming? Herself is coming. So, emphatic pronouns are directly placed, they are immediately placed after the noun, they are after the noun or pronoun which they emphasize, okay, which they are giving importance to. Okay, so here you can see before herself, she is there and she is the subject. Okay, so herself is what? It is the emphatic pronoun. Now moving to the next or the last pronoun, that is what? Relative pronoun. Now relative pronoun shows us the relationship. It joins two sentences that relate to nouns which have come before. Okay, so ye jo hote hain beta, these pronouns show join two parts or join the parts of sentences, and we'll understand it by seeing an example. I'm writing an example over here. This is Sasha who lives near my house. Here you can see what? That we are talking about Sasha and we are giving the information about Sasha by joining it with a word which is who, and it is only the relative pronoun. Who is acting as a relative pronoun because it is used to join the part of sentences and it gives us the information about the noun. Okay, so this is what? This is the relative pronoun. Now the noun to which a person refers, the noun to which the person is referring, that is the antecedent. Okay, antecedent it is. So the noun, you can see, let's suppose we are taking this example only. What is the antecedent over here? We'll understand it by this example itself. Okay, so here you can see we have joined two sentences. What are the two sentences? That is, this is Sasha and the another one is she lives near my house. So what you can see over here is that who is relating to the noun which is Sasha. Okay, so यहाँ पर हम Sasha को refer कर रहे हैं, Sasha के बारे में बात कर रहे हैं. So who is relating to the noun which is Sasha? So that is why this is the noun to which a pronoun refers. So that is why Sasha is what? It is an antecedent. Antecedent it is. Okay. Now the relative pronoun agrees with the antecedent in number, gender, and person. Who, whom, and whose are used for the persons only. Who, whom, and whose are used for the persons only, and which is used for animals or things. That is the things without life, the non-living things. Okay. Now let's see one example. Bina picked up the puppy which was trembling in fear. Okay, so here you can see which is used to refer to the animals we are talking about, the puppy we are talking, okay, which is used to refer to the animal. Okay, now that is used for person, animals, and things. Okay, now relative pronoun should be placed as near as possible to its antecedent. Okay, antecedent. Okay, now this was what? This was the relative pronoun in the last, and we have studied about the 6 type of pronouns over here. That were what? Demonstrative pronouns, possessive pronouns, interrogative pronouns, reflexive pronouns, emphatic pronouns, and relative pronouns. Okay, now we'll move to the exercise of this chapter. Now we are moving to the exercise of this chapter. Exercise A, circle the demonstrative pronouns and underline the demonstrative adjectives in these sentences. So what we have to do is, we need to circle the demonstrative pronouns, okay, and we have to underline the demonstrative adjective. So here you can see, I'm taking the second one, that house at the end of the street is for sale. So here you can see that house is coming, it is coming. House is the noun, and that is describing us about the noun. Okay, so that is what? The adjective. It is demonstrative adjective, and we have to underline it. So we have underlined that over here. So like this, we have to do this exercise. Moving to the next exercise. This is your B exercise now. Underline the interrogative pronouns and circle the interrogative adjectives in these sentences. So what we have to do is, we need to underline all the interrogative pronouns and we have to circle the interrogative adjectives. Okay. So now we are taking, I'm taking your second one. Who is standing at the door? Okay. So here you can see that the who is acting as a pronoun because it is used to what? It is used to ask questions, and they are standing alone. They stand for the noun they are referring to. Okay. So now who is what? It is the interrogative pronoun. That is why we are underlining it, as it is given in the question itself, that underline the interrogative pronoun. So we have underlined it, and in this way you have to do this exercise. Let's move to the other exercise. Now, underline the possessive pronouns and circle the possessive adjectives in these sentences. One has been done for you. Okay, so what we have to do is, we have to underline the possessive pronoun. We have to underline the possessive pronouns in these sentences, and we have to circle the possessive adjectives. Okay, let's take your third one. Our class was awarded a prize for being the best maintained one in the school. Okay, so here you can see our class was awarded a prize. Our class is coming. So here you can see class is, it is a noun. Okay, and before class R is coming, which is showing us the possession. Okay, that whose class it is? It is our class. Okay, so R is what? It is coming with the noun. So that is why possessive adjective it is, and we have to circle it. Okay, so R is the possessive adjective in this sentence. Moving to the next one, you can see over here, is this box of paints yours? So, yahan par aap dekh rahe hain that what is coming, is this box of paints yours? So, now yours is acting as a possessive pronoun over here because it is standing alone and it is showing the possession. Okay, it is not coming with the noun. So, yours is what? It is the possessive pronoun. Okay, now in this way you have to do this exercise. Let's move to the other exercise. The exercise, fill in the blanks with correct reflexive pronouns. So we have to fill the blanks with the correct reflexive pronouns. Let's take this one. We applied dash to the job of cleaning the house. So for what were reflexive pronoun? The subject, or as I said you, the doer of the action is the receiver of the action. Okay, so here what is the doer? We. So it will relate, it will only come according to the subject. So that is why answer is what? Ourselves. If in place of he was written, then himself would have come over here. Okay, now in this way you have to do this exercise. Let's move to the other exercise. So now as you can see over here that it's your last exercise, join these pair of sentences using relative pronouns. Okay, so we are given with two sentences and we have to join these two sentences with relative pronouns. Okay, so now let's take the third one. The film was appreciated. It had an interesting plot. Okay. Now the film, we are talking about the film. Okay, so, okay, after that the relative pronoun will come because it should be placed, the relative pronoun should be placed as near as possible to its antecedent. Okay, now which will come over here because it is referring to the subject, which is what? The film. Okay, so now the film which had an interesting plot was appreciated. So this is how we have joined the two sentences. Okay, in this way you have to do this exercise, and I hope you have understood both the chapters well, chapter 19 and chapter 20. Please do the bookwork which has been sent to you. With this video, stay fit, stay at your home. Thank you.